we shout with joy, we rise and sing the will of God is done. A new day dawns and the dream lives, the Son of God has come. Fight bravely to crush Satan, God's power will be revealed in the children of our Father, the singing Top of the World. Such a feeling's coming over me. There is wonder in most everything I see. Not a cloud for
passing of Reverend Moon in early September 2012 brought tens of thousands of mourners from all over the world to Korea to pay their respects to this religious pioneer and peace-loving global citizen. The mourners included former heads of state, prominent religious leaders, and civil and political figures from many countries. Reverend Moon's life was one of selfless dedication to the mission of bringing peace to the world. At the age of only 15, in response to an intense spiritual encounter with Jesus, Reverend Moon made a solemn promise to live his life in the service of God and humanity. Despite the hardships of living in an occupied land, experiencing the ravages of war and the harsh deprivations of a North Korean labor camp, he never wavered in this determination. From extremely humble beginnings in a divided and war-torn Korea, he began to build a movement of people who dared to share his vision of a good and peaceful world. After years of intense searching, study, and prayer, he published The Divine Principle, a teaching which has led many to a deeper understanding of Scripture and of God's providence.
What has injected a new energy and new life in my ministry is to have come to discover the essence of the divine principle, which contains the spiritual principles that are deeply rooted in the Bible.
Known primarily as a religious leader, Reverend Moon worked in many other fields of human life to promote the welfare of all humankind and to champion the sharing of technology. He paid particular attention to the ocean and the fishing industry, developing many enterprises to help alleviate the problem of hunger around the world. Reverend Moon also had a great love for sports and the arts, especially as a means to inspire harmony and strengthen moral character, and founded many organizations such as the Peace Cup for soccer, the Little Angels, and the Universal Ballet. In 1971, he came to America, a nation he understood to play a crucial role in the providence of God. He was especially concerned about the breakdown of the family and the spread of atheistic materialism. And he spoke passionately at venues all over the nation, including a packed Madison Square Garden. And at the Yankee Stadium, despite a ferocious storm just moments before he spoke. And at the Washington Monument, in front of an audience of 300,000.
민족적으로 결성된 미국은 통일 세계의 모형이니 미국의 날이 센 하나님의 축복은 미국만을 위한 축복이 아니라 하나님이 다 같은 자녀로서의 전 세계 형제 자매들에게 나눠주어야 할 축복인 것을 확실히 알고.
He also met with prominent U.S. leaders to remind them of America's true purpose and mission. But some saw the success of his ministry as a threat, and negative campaigns began to emerge, creating misunderstanding about the man and the movement. This culminated in Reverend Moon's imprisonment in 1984 on charges of tax evasion. A broad spectrum of religious and political leaders rallied in support of Reverend Moon, recognizing that this was actually a case of religious persecution.
None of us is secure until all of us are secure.
Despite this unfair treatment, he continued to invest in America. Concerned about the liberal bias in the nation's capital, he founded the Washington Times in 1982. While many were skeptical, the newspaper soon became known as a champion for freedom, faith, and family values.
The American people know the truth. And you, my friends at the Washington Times, have told it to them. Together we rolled up our sleeves and got to work. And, oh yes, we won the Cold War.
Teaching that the family is the school of love and the cornerstone of peace, Reverend Moon conducted cross-cultural marriage blessings for both newlyweds and previously married couples.
The blessing is like having a shield around your marriage.
Marriage represents the marriage between God and His bride. He wants to be one with you, not just in your church, but in your marriage.
Reverend Moon founded the American Clergy Leadership Conference, one of the most racially and religiously diverse coalitions of faith leaders in America. Reverend Moon's mission went far beyond Christianity, and he invested wholeheartedly in interfaith dialogue, bringing Jews, Christians, and Muslims together through the Middle East Peace Initiative. Concerned that the voice of religion should be involved at the highest level of peace building, he initiated the call for an interfaith council to be established at the United Nations. Even well into his 80s, Father Moon, along with Mother Moon and his family, continue to conduct peace tours, visiting nations around the world and embracing all of God's people with his love and teaching.
Here's a man that was well aged in 2001, but he preached 50 nights in 50 states, and he preached from anywhere from an hour and a half to 2 hours each night.
To the end of his days, Reverend Moon never stopped speaking of God's will for the world. Behind every great man is a great woman. And true mother, Dr. Hak-Jahan Moon, stood by her husband's side for over 50 years. She is now leading the movement forward as we continue to build on the strong worldwide foundation laid down together with her husband. Mother Moon also embarked on numerous speaking tours of her own. Since 1992, she has led the Women's Federation for World Peace in countries all over the world, where it continues to carry on reconciliation and humanitarian work. After bidding farewell to Father Moon, along with the tens of thousands gathered at the newly built Peace World Center, she encouraged us to keep moving forward and to realize Father Moon's vision of God's good and peaceful world.
부모님께서 활동하셨던 모든 업적들을 다시 재조명하면서 1971년 미국으로 가시면서 미국에게 나는 의사로서 소방수로서 왔다 하신 말씀은 하늘이 그토록 준비하셔서 자유세계의 보루로 세워놓았던 미국이 본래의 하늘의 뜻을 받드는 방향과는 다른 퇴폐문화, 가정파괴, 공산주의 사상으로 그 존망의 갈림길에 있었던 미국을 1971년, 80년대 미국의 경각심을 일깨우고 종교 문제라든지 사상 문제에 있어서 공산주의의 위협을 받고 있는 미국을 구하고자 혈연단신 가신 길이었습니다. 미국을 살리시는 그 뜻은 하늘 부모님의 뜻을 받들어 세계 인류를 구하기 위한 목적이셨습니다. 그리하여 흔들리는 자유세계 민주주의가 흔들리는 그 나라에 아버님께서는 용서하라, 사랑하라, 하나 되어라. 미국의 모든 선한 사람들에게 깨우쳐 주셨습니다. 그리하여 몸소 사랑을 실천하셨습니다. 참 부모님 수고하셨습니다. 참 부모님 사랑합니다. 참 부모님 그립습니다. 크신 사랑 앞에 마지막 우리들의 모든 힘과 능력과 노력을 다하여서 부모님이 보여주신 그 뜰 아래 일심 일체 일념 일화로서 그동안에 여러분들이 수고한 모든 업적에 대해서 감사합니다. 이제 우리의 목표는 뚜렷해졌습니다. 우리가 가는 곳에는 참 부모님, 하늘 부모님이 함께 하심을 잊지 마시기 바랍니다.
나의 자식이 아니더냐? 설사 너희가 진정 죽을 죄를 지었다 한들 부모된 마음에 어찌 원수되자 할 수 있을까? 부모 자식 지간에 심판 따위는 없다.
참부모와 하늘 부모님의 심정이란 절대 절대 사랑 그리고 절대 복종 결단코 상하주종의 관계를 원한 게 아니야. 도리어 하늘 부모님의 우리를 향한 사랑의 마음
어떤 타락과 죄악의 구덩이에 빠져도 우린 언제나 너희를 사랑하고 기다린다. 심판 따윈 결코 있을 수 없어. 어떤 잘못도 모두 용서할 테니 나와 살자. 이것이 부모의 마음.
take these hands and lift them up, for I am not the strength to praise you near enough. I have nothing, I have nothing without you. Take my voice and pour it out. Let it sing the songs of mercy I have found. I have nothing, I have nothing without you.
Because